morning, Broken Arrow, and welcome to this year's final episode of GMBA. I'm your host, Hunter, here with Tori. Thanks for joining us.
For this last episode, we are going to do some things a little differently this week.
What does that mean?
You're just gonna have to find out, Hunter. For now, though, let's hand it off to Darian Snyder for a look back at last week and this week's Weekly Rewind.
Hey guys, it's Darian back for the final time this school year. And wow, what a way to go out. The last week has been quite a special time to be a Tiger, as there were state champions, championship game appearances, and a Special Olympics send-off, and much, much more. Starting off, a giant shout-out goes to the boys' track team for finishing off an amazing season, with the state championship last weekend and more. This season, the boys set 13 school records and claimed titles in the 4x100 relay, the 4x200 relay, as well as the pole vault. Congrats again on an amazing season. The girls' track team set 15 school records, won state in the 3200 meter run and 4x400 relay, as well as finishing top three in 8 different events, en route to a runner-up finish at the state meet. After winning their regional, Broken Arrow Baseball rode that momentum and won the first 3 games of the state tournament before falling in a tight contest with Edmond Santa Fe at One Oak Field on Saturday in the championship game. The Tigers finished the season with a 24-11 record. Great job, guys. We also want to say congrats to the boys tennis team for the solid performance at the state tournament, highlighted by Connor Collins and Cole Hubert placing 3rd in 2 doubles. All of the tennis players made it to day 2 of the state competition. Congrats again, guys.
The girls soccer team made it all the way to the state semifinals last week before losing a tight contest to Norman North. Congrats, ladies, on a great season.
Yesterday, the amazing Special Olympians had a big send-off for their Special Olympics competition that is going on today until Friday in Stillwater. We want to wish all the Special Olympians good luck in all of their events. You will do great. Obviously, I can't forget about graduation. A giant congrats goes out to all the graduating seniors. Your hard work has finally paid off, and we want to wish all of you the best of luck in the future. Now, before I go, I want to remind any juniors and sophomores who enjoy writing, storytelling, and reading BuzzFeed that the newspaper class is for you. Newspaper is currently looking for students to join their class. Newspaper students write stories that are featured on BHSPulse.com as well as in the yearbook. The application to join this class is available on the top of the BHSPulse.com website. See your name on a byline and build your future. It's not too late to change your schedule and get in a class that will prepare you for your future. If you have any questions, stop by and see Ms. Spencer in Main 106. Well, that's all I've got for you this year. Thanks for letting me bring you the Weekly Rewind. It's been real, BA. See you next time.
Good morning, students and staff, and welcome back to my last segment of the big news this year. And I have some really important news to share. The 2018 to 2019 school year has officially been extended until Monday, June 4th. So that means Monday, May 20th, will not be the last day of school. State officials sent a memo to all school districts earlier this morning stating the change in an effort to, and I quote, make Oklahoma the smartest state ever. They are extending school days for all districts, and personally, I'm very excited. And another exciting news, the Smartest State in America initiative will move high school starting times up to 6:30 a.m. So get those alarms ready. And some other quick notes that you need to know, all SAT scores have been invalidated. So yeah, there's that. Good luck taking the state test again. And finally, there are not exemptions this semester. So for all of you people expecting to be gone on June 1st and June 4th final dates, well, that stinks for you. And in other news, many of you may have noticed that me and Hunter switched hosting duties midway through the year. And why is that, you may ask? Well, Hunter loves being the center of attention, and he begged and cried and threw his senior weight around until Mr. Couch finally gave him one of the main hosting duties. It's all good though, I'm a team player. But Hunter might want to check his coffee. Well, that's all I've got for you guys this year. It's been real. I'll see you guys next year. Back to you guys.
Okay, well, next up, Ethan is back with this final segment of the year, graduation from a senior's perspective. Here's the graduation edition of What's Poppin'.
We're here, it's like 9:24, it's 9:24. We're about to load the bus. So what's poppin', guys? We're going to be okay, finally.
Heck yeah.
Hey, Savannah, what's poppin'?
Nothing much.
Are you excited for this? Oh, I'm so sorry.
I mean, no.
No?
It's just gonna take a long time.
It is gonna take a long time, but it's gonna be so much fun. What's up, guys? So we're here at the BOK Center. Oh my gosh, it's like actually happening. What's up? We're here in the BOK Center. So we're finally heading into the arena, I'm guessing. Dude, we finally did it. I did it! So we're here at Incredible Pizza, and I don't know, it's awesome. What's big poppin'?
Tell you what, Project Grad is big poppin'.
That's right.
It's about to go off. Oh. It's only 12:05, but everyone's already having a good time.
Poppin', what's poppin'? We graduated.
Yeah, we did.
We did it. It's over. That's it for the segment. We had a lot of fun, a lot of good times at Project Grad at graduation. This is it. This is the last episode of What's Poppin'. Thanks guys for tuning in every week. I really appreciate all the support. Thanks for everything, Broken Arrow High School. Love you guys. Good night. Goodbye.
Thanks, Ethan. So, Hunter, how's graduation for you?
You know what? It was just absolutely amazing. I can't believe it's finally over, I think.
Well, it's not over quite yet.
What do you mean?
Well, there's several events happening this week, and Rianne and Morgan are here with some info, plus a few summer tips for everyone. Take it away, guys.
Hey guys, I'm Morgan.
And I'm Ri.
And this is the week ahead. There's not a whole lot going on now besides finals, but we do have a few important announcements for you guys.
All right, guys, the defending state champion football team has their annual spring game this Saturday, the 18th at noon. Because of the field construction, the game will be at the Broken Arrow Freshman Academy. So come out and check out next year's squad.
And we are excited to announce that there will be a Spirit Bus to Mansfield, Texas on Saturday, August 31st. $65 will cover the ticket, transportation, and dinner, but you will need to bring money for lunch along the way and concessions at the game.
They will leave that Saturday morning and return after the football game late at night. There are limited seats available and it will be on a first-come, first-served basis. Students can pay in full by June 1st to reserve a seat or pay $35 June 1st and $30 July 1st to secure a seat. Checks, cash, or card are accepted. If you have any questions, see Ms. Wellborn in the Student Union.
Also, seniors, after your last semester test is over, please report to the Media Center to return your Chromebooks. You have to return an operational and undamaged Chromebook, Chrome charger, and Chrome case, and bring your student ID or driver's license. If you're exempt from all of semester tests, you must return your equipment prior to leaving for the summer.
Well, that's all we have for you guys this year.
We hope everyone has a great summer.
Bye! Bye.
Thanks, guys. In case you didn't already know, Hunter is going off into the Air Force after high school, and we couldn't be more proud. So in honor of that, we have a little gift for you.
What? What is this?
Airmen, get up right now! You're not a special snowflake! Go, 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 go! It's the eye of the tigers, the thrill of the fight, rising up to the challenge of our rival. And the last known survivor starts to spread in the night. Of his work in us, now is the eye of the
I've been told.
I don't know what I've been told.
Mr. Couch is really old.
Mr. Couch is really old.
I am the tiger.
Wow, that was a lot. Thanks for the gift, I think.
No problem. Next up, check out this segment from the final episode of The Pulse, which will come out later this week, followed by the special video highlighting Teacher of the Year Award winner, Jeannie Moore, at the Star Awards Gala.
All right, guys, it's the last episode of The Pulse. We're gonna need some great ideas to make this episode fantastic. What do you got?
We could do a beach ball party.
I don't know.
Okay.
Hear me out. Jurassic Park skit.
Jurassic Park? Really?
We could totally do a skit where it's like teachers and students trade places.
Seen it.
Dog.
We could do another turkey skit.
You guys have a problem with those turkey suits.
We don't have a problem with the costumes. We have a problem with you.
I mean, we could do another Mason on campus.
I like that idea. Keep talking.
It's always like we love the turkey costumes.
Who wrote this script? It's complete garbage.
What the heck, Mason?
Why'd you delete our script?
You hurt my feelings.
It was funny.
Guys, I'm sorry, but the script was absolute garbage.
I can't believe this, Mason.
Really, Mason?
Mr. Couch, I don't feel too good.
What are you guys looking at? Get back to work.
My reaction was that really my name? Is that really my name? And it was just, I couldn't believe it. I was so surprised but so completely humbled and honored that it was really happening.
Well, I was totally shocked and I wanted to really cry, but I was very honored and happy.
We've lived in Broken Arrow for 20 years, where my kids were raised here, you know, kindergarten through graduation, so I was already vested in that process. I had taught years before and then stayed home, and so I was a volunteer, and then I was a secretary at Liberty Elementary with my kids. So Broken Arrow is not just like me being a teacher at Broken Arrow High School. Broken Arrow is like this is my life. This is my family. This is where I've raised my kids. For me, that makes it so much more impactful.
I'm so glad that Jeannie, who does work so hard day in and day out, not only as just an amazing instructor, but as an amazing role model for our kids, and I'm thrilled for her. It's a very well-deserved honor. We just couldn't be prouder to be the home now of a three-peat.
It's been an honor being a part of letting you know what's going on around campus. I just want to say thank you to the Pulse class and the AeroVision staff. It's been such an experience being a part of this great program. My year wouldn't have been the same without you guys. And to all the student body and staff for making this such an amazing year. And last but certainly not least, thank you to Hunter and David for being such great co-hosts.
I cannot thank everyone in this class enough for being like a second family. But most importantly, I want to thank Greg Spencer and Nolan Couch for all the opportunities that they provide for me. They didn't just help me out with this year in school, they helped me with being a better person. They brought me into this amazing program, and it's gonna be so hard to say goodbye to all these amazing people. So thank you to Ethan, David, Tori, Rian Morgan, Darian, Jacob, Kelsey, Lex, Luke, Mason, Malachi, Sage, Annika, and Tian and Megan. So once again, thank you for everything you've done for me, and I hope to see everyone in the following years.
Before we go, we have a few more special treats for you guys. This job isn't as easy as it seems sometimes, so let's take a look at some of our past bloopers from past episodes of GMBA, and then hang on for one final goodbye from all of the third hour Pulse class. Applications for
Couch made me cry in my dream.
Couch makes me cry in real life. Oh. Good job.
Tomorrow in the school, at the...
Couch isn't my mother.
So you say. This is why my mom doesn't like you.
At least I don't say that's the tea.
I need the monies. I have 36 cents in my checking account.
Indianapolis. At the WGI Indianapolis Indianapolis Regional.
You're fired.
You can't fire her.
Just did.